In a case of mistaken identity, Andreas Christophorus was diced with sulfuric acid on his doorstep in Cornwall 3 years ago. The attacks left him with life-changing injuries, including blindness in one eye. But the mental effects are just as painful.
Very early on, me and Pierre made the decision that my son Theo shouldn't be near the hospital at all. So I didn't see him for close to 3 months. And that was my biggest fear. How would he be with me? How would he react to seeing me? My wife, Pierre, got him out of the car. And I went up to him and he looked at me and he just grabbed Pierre. And my heart sank. But then when I started talking and he recognised my voice, he knew it was me. And the second he knew it was me, he just stuck his arms out to me and gave me the biggest hug in the world.
His perpetrator, who was originally given a life sentence, has now had his jail term cut to a minimum of 8 years. Acid attacks are not new, but there's been a sharp rise, particularly in London, with more than 450 last year, nearly double the number in 2015, according to figures from the Metropolitan Police. Police say they're seeing some links between criminal gangs and the recent increase of corrosive substances. Traditionally known to be a weapon of choice in honour attacks around the world, acid is now being used in gang-related violence in the UK. And doctors are on the receiving end.
The numbers have certainly increased. We did some research a few years ago and we looked at all of our chemical assaults. From one to two per year on average, we admitted 20 cases last year and we have seen more than that already this year.
One high-profile acid attack was here at this nightclub in East London earlier this year. 22 people were hurt, two lost their sight in one eye and others suffered burns. One of them was 26-year-old Sadie Wright, who's been having treatment for facial and head burns.
I'm very happy, let's see.
The physical injuries have healed, but she no longer spends as much time with her friends.
Going out was always me and my friends, we love it. So my friends are a bit sad that I don't really go out anymore. They don't even ask me anymore because I just go and tell them no.
For those left with long-lasting disfigurements, it's also a harsh reality, underlining the devastating misuse of toxic substances. Adina Campbell, BBC News.